Population is defined as group of interbreeding individuals occupying a given area. The arrangement of individual in a given area is known as pattern of population dispersion. This is Gayatri. Welcome back to BioSchool. In today's video, I'm going to explain you what are the factors that are responsible for the pattern of population dispersion, types of pattern of population dispersion, and how can we statistically calculate population dispersion pattern. This is very simple and very important. Please do watch my video till the end. Hey everyone, hope you all are doing well. And today I am with another topic of population ecology, that is patterns of population dispersion. At the end we are going to solve CSIR NET question related to this topic. So here you go. What is population? We know that population is defined as a group of interbreeding individuals occupying the same area at the same time. Then what is pattern of dispersion? Pattern of dispersion is the arrangement of individuals in a given area. The dispersion or the distribution pattern show the relationship between members of a population within a habitat. Patterns are the characteristics of a particular species, and it depends on the environmental condition, that is the availability of resources, climate, soil condition. It also depends on the species growth characteristics and the behavior of animals. Now comes to pattern of population dispersion. The three basic kinds of population dispersions are clumped dispersion. Clumped dispersion means individuals are clustered in a group. Okay, here in diagram you can observe that the individuals are arranged in a groups, that is known as the clumped dispersion. The second one is the uniform dispersion. Uniform dispersion where the individuals are equally spaced apart. Okay, here you can see the individuals are uniformly arranged. That is known as the uniform dispersion. And third one is the random dispersion. The random dispersion means there is no predictable pattern and the individuals are arranged here and there. Okay, so this one is the random dispersion. Now we will see in details about each type of dispersion and its cause. So here you go. The first one is clumped dispersion. Clumped means the cluster. Individuals are arranged in a cluster, and it is the most common dispersion pattern. Okay. Then now, what are the causes of clumped dispersion pattern? The first point is that resources in the environment are tend to be clustered. Okay. For example, certain plants, they do better or they grow better in moist condition. And the moisture is greater in the low-lying lands. So here in diagram you can see the plants are clustered in the low-lying lands. And another example is that social behavior of animals that also promote the clumped dispersion patterns. Many animals are clumped into flocks and the herds. That is, they form a large group, they live together, migrate from one place to another place, they feed together. Okay, that also lead to the clumped dispersion pattern, like social predisposition to form the groups. For example, for the thermoregulation and for food searching and to protect from the predators, the animals also form the groups, or they clustered. And another point is that there is a tendency of progeny to remain near the parents. That also lead to the formation of clumped dispersion pattern in a population. Okay. So if you got a question that which dispersion pattern is common in population, that is clumped dispersion pattern. Next is the uniform dispersion. Uniform means individuals are spaced equally, more or less equally apart from each other. In uniform dispersion, individuals of populations are spaced more or less evenly. Then what are the causes of uniform dispersion? Let's see. uniform dispersion results from the social interaction is between some nesting birds, which tend to keep an even distance from each other. Okay, here are the nesting birds. They keep an equal distance from each other. Okay, this is the social interaction. And the maintenance of the distance is to avoid fight for food or any type of the interference. And the another cause, it may be the territoriality. Territoriality between the animals also cause the uniform dispersion pattern. Territoriality means the defense of a fixed area against the other individuals to protect the resources, and it may be for the reproductive opportunities also. Okay. In some plants, they secrete the toxin that inhibit the growth of the nearby plant. We know that that phenomenon is known as the allopathy. Okay. So by all these methods, like for the social interaction, or for the territoriality point of view, the individuals, they arranged in a uniform pattern. Okay. Now comes to the third pattern, that is the random dispersion. In the random dispersion, individuals are spaced independently of one another. Okay. They are spaced independently of one another. This is the rarest dispersion pattern. Okay. Why? Because in nature, resources are rarely randomly spaced. Then what are the causes of random dispersion? The first cause is, where the resources are common and abundant, the dispersion patterns of plants may be random. Okay. If the resources are the abundant and the common resources are the present, there we find the random dispersion. Like example, dandelions and other plants that have wind dispersed seeds, and the seed spread widely and sprout where they fall, as long as the environment is favorable. Okay, so that leads to the random dispersion pattern. Like the plant, they can grow any place because the resources are abundantly present, but this is the rarest condition in the environment. Some animals also exhibit the random dispersion pattern. There is no territoriality. Okay, in the random dispersion pattern, there is no territoriality. Individuals like a grey kangaroo are spaced randomly in population where cover is widespread. So now we know what is clumped dispersion, uniform dispersion, and random dispersion. Now we will see how can we statistically determine the distribution patterns. This is very simple, and you will get a question from this part. Let's see what is it. Okay. There are various ways to determine the distribution pattern of species. The one of the statistical method is variance mean ratio. It is used to determine if a distribution is clumped, or it is a uniform, or it is random. Okay. If the ratio of variance and mean is equal to 1, then that is called the randomly distributed population. Okay. If it is equal to 1. If the ratio of variance and mean is greater than 1, then that leads to clumped distribution. If it is less than 1, then that leads to uniform distribution. Okay. If the ratio of variance to mean is equal to 1, then that is randomly distributed population. If it is greater than 1, then that is clumped distribution. If it is less than 1, then that leads to uniform distribution. Hope you have got a clear idea about population dispersion pattern, and now you will able to solve CSIR NET question related to this topic. So let's see. This is the previous year CSIR UGC NET question. What is the question? Question is, the following table shows the mean and variance of population densities of species A, B and C. Okay, so here the species A, species B and species C, and the mean of species A, B, C as well as the variance is given. Based on the above, which of the following statement is correct? Okay, so what is the question? Here the mean and variance is given, and here it is asking about the which species shows which type of distribution. So how can we calculate? We can calculate by putting the formula variance divided by mean. Okay, let's see for the species 1. For species 1, the variance is 5.05. Okay, the variance is 5.05, variance by mean. Variance, I just represented it in by V, and mean as M. So variance is 5.05 and here mean is 5.3. Okay, so 5.05 divided by 5.3 equal to 0.95. This value is equal to 1. If the ratio of variance to mean is equal to 1, then which pattern of population distribution it is? It is random. Okay, so this one is the random distribution. Now comes to for the species B. In species B, the variance is 0.35, whereas mean is 7.05. So by dividing the variance with the mean, we got the value, it is 0.04. This value is less than 1. If the ratio of variance to mean is less than 1, then it shows which type of distribution pattern? This is uniform. This is uniform. Let's see for species C. In species C, the variance is 50.5, whereas the mean is 5.30. So by dividing variance with the mean, we got 9.5 is the ratio of variance to mean, and this value is greater than 1. If the ratio of variance to mean is greater than 1, then the species is shows which type of distribution? That is clumped distribution. So let's see which option is correct. Option A, species A and B show uniform distribution. No, it's wrong. Okay, let's see option B. Species A shows random distribution. Yes, species A shows the random distribution is correct. Species B shows uniform distribution. Species B shows the uniform distribution. This is also correct. And species C shows clumped distribution. Yes, species C also shows clumped distribution. So the correct answer is option B. Okay, let's see the option C and D. Species A and B show clump distribution. No, it's wrong. Species A shows clump distribution. No, it's not. So it's also wrong. So the correct option is option B. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video and it is helpful to you, then please like and share with your friends, juniors and the seniors. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Bye bye. See you in my next video.